Hey, Shalom. This is Howard One by Yasha Allah of the Lions Den Camp. I want to say Kar Halayim La Yahweh by Hashem Yahushai, by Hashem Harakakodash Ma'ama. Alright, double honor to the elder apostles of GMS and their elders. Shalom to you, Akim, Nagwathim, and children that believe in sincerity and truth around the four corners of the earth. This is going to be a quick lesson dealing with Daniel chapter 12 from 11 all the way to 13. Alright. Break down this parable. Now this is a twofold parable. All right, one, the situation already happened during the time around 70 AD, and ultimately, it's a reflection of what's going to happen in these last days. All right, us being in captivity and coming out of that captivity. So let's get into it real quick while it's on my spirit. This is Daniel chapter 12 and 11. And from the time, actually, in 10, many shall be purified and made white. All right. But the wicked shall do wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand, but the wise shall understand. All right. So the wicked, 2/3 of our people, cannot understand this doctrine. And from the time that the daily sacrifice shall be taken away, and the abomination that maketh desolate set up, there shall be 1,290 days. All right. And now, when was the daily sacrifice taken away? That was during the time of the Jewish-Roman wars. All right, 66 A.D. Going all the way up to about 70 A.D. So this was the precursor to 70 AD right here. All right. Let me get this. All right, I'm gonna read this. Of course, we already know the dates from 66 to 73 AD. This was the, what was called the first Jewish-Roman wars. I think the last one was called the Battle of Carcoba or something like that. All right. It was called the Third Jewish War, the Battle of Kakba, all right, revolt. So so let's get into it real quick, all right? But before I did, I'm going to get the precept one more time, all right? Daniel 12 and 11, and from the time that the daily sacrifice, all right, sacrifice daily in the temple shall be taken away, and the abomination that maketh desolate set up, there shall be 1,290 days. Now this 1,290 days ultimately adds up to 3.5 years. All right, and parabolically, it would be 350 for this current time we're in today. But back then, it represented what it said, but it would be in years, 3.5 years, all right? So let's deal with this first half, because then you had the second part that happened. It says, blessed is he that waiteth and cometh to the 1,305 and 30 days, I mean. All right, so that would be about 3.6. So let's get to it, man. All right, you see it right here, 1,290 days. Okay, that's the first half. It'll be 3.5. All right, so basically 3.5. All right, so let's get into the story real quick. Now, from 66 A.D. all the way to 70, that would be 4 years. But the battle, the real level of Esau bringing the hammer down on our people didn't start until 67 AD, all right, which will leave you about 3 years all the way to 70 AD. So let's get a little understanding on it, all right? Sometimes called the Great Jewish Revolt. The Jewish War was the first of three major rebellions by the Jews against the Roman Empire, right? And the persecution of the Jews didn't really stop until around 311 AD with Emperor Galerius, when he set in place the Edict of Toleration, when they started tolerating Jews, if you want to call it that. All right. It says, was the first of three major rebellions by the Jews against the Roman Empire, fought in Roman-controlled Judea, resulting in the destruction of Jewish towns, the replacement of its people, the displacement of its people. We were dispersed, scattered, especially into the western coast of Africa and all over the lands at that time, the known world, and the appropriation of land for Roman military use, as well as the destruction of the Jewish temple and polity, okay? So now, the Great Revolt began in the year 66 Common Era, during the 12th year of the reign of Nero, okay? So that's when Nero died around this time. I think he died in 68 AD, if I'm not mistaken, right before Vespasian took office, all right? But anyway, Nero, that devil, he the one that established Vespasian to set up a military excursion into Israel. So it says here, originating in Roman and Jewish religious tensions, the crisis escalated due to anti-taxation protests. See, they didn't want Israel didn't want to pay those taxes. They, you know, we were against taxation, and attacks upon Roman citizens by the Jews. The Roman governor, Gessius Florus, responded by plundering the Second Temple. See that? So that's when they plundered the Second Temple, the daily sacrifice was taken away, you know? By plundering the Second Temple, claiming the money was for the emperor. So they were lying. So when our people rebelled because of the taxation and started attacking Romans, Edomites, this guy, Gessius Florus, responded by plundering the Second Temple. All right, so let's see. Upon taking office in Caesarea, Florus, all right, began favoring local Greek population of the city over the Jewish population. The local Greek population noticed Florus's policies and took advantage of the circumstances. One notable instance of provocation occurred while the Jews were worshiping at their local synagogue, and a Hellenist sacrificed several birds on top of a chamber pot at the entrance of the synagogue, an act that rendered the building ritually unclean. All right, so they started coming in there, desecrating our temple, man, and it made it unclean. In response to this action, the Jews sent a group of men to petition Florus for redress. Despite accepting a payment of 8 talents to hear the case, Florus refused to listen to the complaints and instead had the petitioners imprisoned. Damn. It's cold, man. All right, so they started messing with our sacrifices. You know, our means of sacrifice. So this was around that time, going into the mid area of 66 AD. All right, so it says the Roman governor, Gessius Florus, responded by plundering the Second Temple, claiming the money was for the emperor, which was a lie. All right. And the next day, launching a raid on the city. Wow. Arrested numerous senior Jewish figures, man. So they were, you know, by around that time, we couldn't go just sacrifice like we would like to. This prompted a wider and larger scale rebellion in a Roman military garrison of Judea, was quickly overrun by the rebels, by Israelites. While the pro-Roman king Herod Agrippa II, right, he ran, together with the Roman officials, fled Jerusalem. So they ran away from Jerusalem. Resist the devil and he'll flee. As it became clear the rebellion was getting out of control, Cestius Gallus, the legate of Syria, brought in the Syrian army based on the legion 12 Fulminata and reinforced by auxiliary troops to restore order and quell the revolt. Despite initial advances in the conquest of Jaffa, the Syrian legion was ambushed and defeated by the Jewish rebels at the Battle of Beth Horon, with 6,000 Romans massacred and the legion's Aquila lost. That way you have 3.5. That's that half right here going into the half of the year. So now check this out. During 66 AD, the Judean Provisional Government was formed, all right? The Judean Provisional Government was formed in Jerusalem. And so provisional government, we'll see what that is. Just like now they're giving out provisions. That's how you know something's in a collapsed state. The Judean Provisional Government was a short-lived de facto governing entity of Judea, which was established in the year 66 CE, Common Era, by Judean rebel forces of the Pharisee and the Sadducee parties, and aimed to govern the Jewish Judean state. The government functioned until the Zealot Temple siege in the year 68 CE, when most of its leaders were massacred in the inter-rebel struggle. Sheesh. All right, so that's what the Judean Provisional Government represented, which was started around the mid-66 Common Era time. Was formed in Jerusalem, including former high priest Ananias, Joseph Ben Gurion, and Joshua Ben Gamla, elected as leaders. These are all Jakes. All right, I'm gonna skip all these names. No. It says what? Joseph Ben Matityahu. My goodness. Yahweh. Basically, Josephus, that was, you know, so he had a Hebrew name, was appointed the rebel commander in Galilee, right? Josephus made it out of this war. All right, let me get to the point. Commander in Galilee, and Eleazar Ben Hananiah as the commander in Edom. Later in Jerusalem, an attempt by Menahem Ben Yehoiada, leader of the Sicarii, to take control of the city failed. He was executed, and the remaining Sicarii were ejected from the city. All right, so here's the point. The experienced and unassuming general Vespasian was given the task by Nero of crushing the rebellion in Judea province, man. All right. Given four legions. Sheesh. All right. So, of and assisted by forces of King Agrippa II, Vespasian invaded Galilee in 67 AD. See that? So that's when the first invasion happened with Vespasian. And that'll take you into all up to 69. And then that's when Vespasian brought in, I think that's around the time Nero died. But that's when Vespasian brought in his son Titus. All right. So he invaded Galilee in 67 AD, man. Okay. When the Roman general Vespasian invaded Galilee under the orders of Nero in order to crush the great revolt of Judea. Okay, so, all right, now, so we don't get too far from the scripture. Let's get back into it. Daniel 12 and 11. And from the time that the daily sacrifice, all right, meaning they would go up daily to the temple and sacrifice freely. And now that was stopped around the mid-halfway point through 66 AD, all right, CE. And the abomination that maketh desolate set up, all right, and that happened after 69 AD with Titus, all right. There shall be 1,290 days, all right. So that would be what? 3.5 years, all the way to 70 AD, all right. About 3.5 years, or you could say 4 years, going in from 66 AD all the way to 70, or it'd be 3.5, because everything really kicked off the halfway point through 66 AD, and then they went in there and attacked, took Galilee in 67. All right. It says, blessed is he that waiteth and cometh to the 1,305 and 30 days. That'd be, in our terminology, we'll say 1,335. All right, so this will take you to approximately 4 years, you know, or 3 years further into the future, okay? So totaling 3.5 and 3.6, it would be about 7 years, all right, if you want to sum it up. All right, I'm not going to go through this whole thing because it'll take you back all the way until 586 BC, all right, into the rebuilding of the temple around 516 with the walls being built. But that's the first temple. But now we're dealing with the fall and the rise of the second temple and the spiritual third temple. All right, this is Daniel 9 to 26, just to get to the point. And after 3 score and 2 weeks, all right, 3 score and 2 weeks, all right, after 3 score and 2 weeks shall the Messiah be cut off. So this is basically saying after the time of John Hyrcanus, all right, around 115 or so BC, and that would go into the time when after 168 in 164, when the temple was rededicated during the time of the Maccabees, then you had the Hasmonean dynasty, and then the Hyrcanus, and them, you know, and they set something up called the Free State or Independent Israel again. So the Lord kept His promise to us, and we weren't over the Romans or the Greeks, but we were living alongside of them, all right? So So now that opened the way for the Messiah to be born and the Herodian dynasty to come into power. So that was, you know. So after the rededicating of the temple and the Hyrcanian dynasty, then you had the Messiah born, okay, during the time of the Herodian dynasty, 4 BCE. So after that time, the Messiah must be cut off, meaning he was crucified. They cut him off from this earth. All right. But not for himself. All right. He did it for the sins of Israel. And the people of the prince that shall come shall destroy the city and the sanctuary. So who is that talking about? That lets you know that these parabolic math equations dealing with the 1290 and the 1335, that's talking about back then during the times of 70 AD, and it spiritually compares to now with the 350 years spoken of in Revelation 11. All right. So from that time, the Messiah is going to be cut off, meaning he's going to be born and cut off. That goes into Revelation 12. I'm not going to get it with the dragon chasing after the woman birthing a child, the Messiah. And the people of the prince that shall come shall destroy the city and the sanctuary. See? So the people of Vespasian, the Vespasian dynasty, they destroyed our people and they destroyed the sanctuary, you know, the city. All right, this is John 14 and 30. Hereafter, I will not talk much with you, right? Because Yahweh Shah had to leave. He was on the right hand. He's on the right hand of the Father. And he went to the spirit realm, took his physical body into the spirit realm. All right, so hereafter, I will not talk much with you. You know, we're going to move it by faith. For the prince of this world cometh and have nothing in me, man. Who's the prince of this world? It'd be Vespasian and ultimately Titus, okay? Because Vespasian took Galilee all up until about 69 AD. And then you had, what's his name? Titus. That was sent in there, man. He was made the emperor, and he was sent in there. Okay, let's get into that. All right, let me get to the point. Where's it at? All right, so it says here, within several months, Vespasian and his son Titus took over the major Jewish strongholds of Galilee and finally overran Jotapatha, which was under the command of Josephus, as well as subdued Terachiah, which brought an end to the war in Galilee. Driven from Galilee, zealots, meaning compassionate brothers, like revolutionaries, rebels, and thousands of the refugees arrived in Jerusalem, creating political turmoil, right? Because it was all in disagreement with each other. Confrontation between the mainly Sadducee Jerusalemites, right, which had a mixture of Greek customs in their beliefs, Jerusalemites and the mainly Zealot factions of the Northern Revolt under the command of John Giscala, all right? So anyway, erupted in bloody violence with Idumeans entering the city and fighting by the side of the Zealots. So these were Jakes that were in the land of Idumea. So, yeah, man, once Titus got involved, it said, after a lull in the military operations owing to civil war, and political turmoil in Rome, Vespasian was called to Rome and appointed as emperor in 69. With Vespasian's departure, Titus moved. See, there you go. So, like, yep. So, Vespasian was made the emperor in 69 because he took the place of Nero. All right. And Titus moved to besiege the center of rebel resistance in Jerusalem in early 70 AD. All right. So that's when, once his dad, Vespasian, was made emperor, that made Titus the prince. The first two walls of Jerusalem were breached within 3 weeks, but a stubborn rebel standoff prevented the Roman army from breaking the third and thickest wall. Following a brutal 7-month siege, during which zealot infighting resulted in the burning of the entire food supplies of the city. Wow. The Romans finally succeeded in breaching the defenses of the weakened Jewish forces in the summer of 70 AD. Following the fall of Jerusalem in the year 71, Titus departed for Rome. He left the legion to defeat the remaining Jewish strongholds, including Herodium, all right? The Roman campaign ended with the Romans' success at the siege of Masada in 73/74. That's why the scriptures keep saying 3.5, man, it's gonna bleed into 66 AD, which is like the halfway point, all the way up to 67, to where they took Galilee, where they really kicked off. And yet from there, you have 3 years all the way up until 70 AD. And then from there, you have from 70 AD, and then going in 71, that's when they took Jerusalem, all the way up to 73, going to 74, which would be 3.6, all right? A little more than 3.5 years. So it's right there, man, in the scripture. So you got really from 66 all the way to 74, all right? But if you go from 66 to 73, it matches up with this precept prophecy right here. All right, Daniel 9:26. And after 62 weeks, shall Messiah be cut off. So that's around the time after John Hyrcanus and the Herodian dynasty, and then Yahushua was born. Then he was cut off from this world, but not for himself, right? It was for the children of Israel. And the people of the prince that shall come shall destroy the city and the sanctuary. Who is that? Titus, all right? They said, the prince of this world cometh. And from the Vespasian dynasty, that prince was Titus, all right? And he was so praised that his brother Domitian built the Colosseums with the gold that he stole, and they built the ark commemorating Titus. All right, the devil, the prince of this world. And the end thereof shall be with a flood, man. Just like today, they're rushing in as a flood. All right, the spiritual right here. And unto the end of the war, desolations are determined. So all the way up until 74 AD. And then that's when things started calming down again, all right? And those that listened to the Lord, a lot of them made it out. He said, flee into the Judean hills. A lot of them, like Zechariah, they ran the opposite way. You know, I forgot what it was called, man. I got to pull it up. It began with an M, I think. It was a place that Herod built. And they ran there, in Masada, instead of running to the Judean hills like the Lord told them to. All right, so now let's get to the point. 27, and he shall confirm the covenant with many for 1 week. So what's that 1 week? All right, so if you understand, 1 week in our terms would be like 7 days, all right? So in years, it would be like 7 years. So from 66 No, so you want to subtract. So we go from 73. All right. Subtract 66 when the rebellion revolt has started, and it kind of ended from 73 going into 74. That would equal 7. All right. 73 take away 66, 7 years. Okay. Even if you wanted to say 74 take away 67, it would still be 7 weeks. Okay. I mean, seven. So like 1 week would be 7. So, and he shall confirm the covenant with many for 1 week. And that was them trying to put Israel back up under their feet and quelch and cut off the rebellions. That's what it means. Confirming their agreement with Israel, the taxation for 1 week. All right. So seven years. It was like a 7-year war. And in the midst of the week, he shall cause the sacrifice and the oblation to cease. What's that? Right? So in the midst of the week would be the halfway point between 66 AD and 73. It would be around 70 AD. So in the midst of the week, in the midst of those 7 years, that's when, where's it at? Here you go, 69, then here you go, boom. Titus moved to besiege the center of rebellion resistance in Jerusalem in early 70 AD. All right, so that's when it really kicked off. Then the halfway point, 70 AD. So this is all prophecy spoken of by Daniel the prophet. All right. So let's keep going. 26, Daniel 9:26, and after 80, Salaki, verse 27, and he shall confirm the covenant with many for 1 week, all right? And in the midst of the week, talking about the Vespasian, because he was made the emperor, and he sent his son Titus in there to quell the rebellion. And in the midst of the week, he shall cause the sacrifice and the oblation to cease, man. So he cut it off. So it was done. All right. For the overspreading of abominations, he shall make it desolate. So that's how you know it's not talking about an actual object. Like they set the statue of Zeus on there and all that. It's talking about the actual people, Edomites, the mystery of iniquity. All right. That do have already worked. They are that abomination that maketh desolate by their imaginations and their overspreading of the abominations that come from them. Enlarging their desires as hell and is as death. All right, so they cause the sacrifice and the oblation to cease under Titus. And for the overspreading of abominations, he shall make it desolate. Even until the consummation and that determined shall be poured upon the desolate, man. So yeah, that was gonna fall on the desolate of our people, which today represent 2/3. All right. So this is Daniel 12:11. And from the time that the daily sacrifice shall be taken away, and the abomination that maketh desolate set up, there shall be 1,290 days. All right, so that goes into about three and a half years. All right, so from the time the revolt started all up until 70 AD. It says, blessed is he that waiteth and cometh to the 1,300 in 5 and 30 days, so that'd be 1335, all right? So that'd be all up until 74 AD. Okay. But go thy way until the end be. And the end really started with Yahweh Shai. And the beginning for Israel. So now, but go thy way until the end be. So Daniel was around during that time of Titus and Vespasian, and he's back here today, like Apostle Hart was saying. Either that or he just recently went to the spirit world, but Daniel was set up in these last days to be right here on the earth. But go thy way till the end be, for thou shalt rest, meaning he died, or rested, and stand in thy lot at the end of days. So you're going to be standing right back up, meaning resurrected, born as a baby in these times, and taught the truth and growing in the truth, all right? So Daniel will be out here today doing this work, ready to be delivered. So that's what this means, man. It goes into the Jewish-Roman revolt wars with Vespasian and Titus coming in there, desecrating the temple and burning down the temple and taking away the sacrifices. All right, now this is the Lord, Yahweh Shai, confirming the prophecy about to happen, spoken of in Daniel. This is Matthew 24:15. When ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation, talking about Titus, Vespasian and Titus, really Titus, spoken of by Daniel the prophet, stand in the holy place. And that's what they were doing. They were fighting and fighting to break through all the rebellions and revolts of our people. Right, our people were fighting for themselves, rightfully so, right? And they finally broke through the walls and they got to Jerusalem, you know, around 70 AD, going into 71. That's when they took it. And they caused it to cease. I mean, it was sacrifices, everything was done. Couldn't do nothing. All right, so it says what? When ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation, see the prophecy came to pass, spoken of by Daniel the prophet, stand in the holy place, whoso readeth, let him understand. Then let them which be in Judea flee into the mountains. But you had some idiots that ran into Masada, and they had to wind up doing a suicide pact and kill themselves. All right. Then let them which be in Judea flee into the mountains. It's talking about the mountains of Judah, the hills. All right, so yeah, man. Let him which is on the housetop not come down to take anything out of his house, neither let him which is in the field return back to take his clothes. And woe unto them that are with child and to them that give suck in those days, right? Because in these days, we're hoping for deliverance. We're hoping for the Lord to take care of us and protect us, you know? And back then, he was saying, woe to them that had child. And woe to them that have children in these days that are really of the elect, I mean, the two-thirds. But pray ye that your flight be not in winter, neither on the Sabbath day. For then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, nor ever shall be, man. Because that was the fall of our nation. You know, we were scattered and destroyed as a people, man. So, yeah. All right. So hopefully this was edifying and clear to any Akim Nakwatim out there that need to understand the scripture, Daniel 12 and 11. Because if you go to Revelations 11, where it speaks about 350 years, that's talking about us being in slavery and then the spirit entering into us after the 350 years of being in bondage. That take you to around the time of Abba Bivens. All right. But this right here is talking about a prophecy that happened from 70 AD, all right, with Titus and Vespasian. All right. So with that, I'm going to say Shalom.